Veteran quarterback Tom Brady notched his 7th Super Bowl win last night, a record, this time at the helm of the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. The accolades for Brady and teammates seem familiar by now, but as Jeffrey Brown reports, while millions tuned in for what's become an American tradition, there were reminders everywhere that it was a game and a year unlike any other.
Whether it was the fewer fans and cutout photos of others, or the ads that were all over the place on whether to address or not address current events, or the fact that, yes, there was a game even amid the pandemic. This was a Super Bowl that in some ways captured our very strange moment. William Roden is a writer at the sports and culture website The Undefeated. He was there last night and joins us now. Thanks for joining us again, Bill Roden. So you wrote in a column today about the difference a year brings. Did last night feel real or surreal from where you sat?
Surreal by a long shot. I've covered a lot of these, and yesterday, last night, sitting in a press box with 70 colleagues in a press box that holds 300, looking at, you know, cardboard cutouts posed as fans, was just really surreal. Yes, the NFL did pull it off, but you got to wonder at what cost. What are going to be the long-term health effects of a lot of players who were hit with COVID? We just don't know. I'm sort of concerned about that.
Well, I mean, talk a little bit more about the NFL, because on the one hand, as you say, they pulled off the season, they pulled off this event. They also were touting a social justice project that they're now putting forward. But there's still so. This is a sport that has so many continuing questions around it and its commitment to social justice, whether you mention Colin Kaepernick or many of the black coaches getting positions. Where do you see things?
Well, you know, this was an economic initiative, basically fulfill a TV contract so the NFL could give the owners basically their stimulus checks. So, you know, fine, that's great. But they wanted to, let's do a Super Bowl so we could see some degree of normalcy. But this was so abnormal. And in terms of social justice, the NFL gets an F. I mean, you have another hiring cycle. One African-American coach who got the job in Houston basically under pressure from the quarterback, Deshaun Watson. No, I mean, still the lack of African-Americans in the executive suite and in the coaching is terrible. It's really terrible. And we're all wondering, what do you do to make these owners do the right thing? I mean, many of them seem to just have a sort of invisible Confederate flag of resistance around the organization, saying, you're not going to make us do anything. So talk is one thing, but actions, we're looking for actions now.
I mentioned, you know, the ads, which also seemed to add to the strangeness of last night, at least watching from home. You could see American corporations groping with how much to address our moment. So some of them went directly to social protests or the pandemic. Others could have been ads that, you know, in any Super Bowl year.
Yeah, we as a nation, you know, just have some really grappling to do with the truth. And the NFL is sort of a metaphor of that groping, a league of where 72% of the players are black. This is about power and control. And the NFL and many of the corporations who are their partners talk a good game, but they're not giving up anything. So, you know, before the Super Bowl, during the Super Bowl, and now after the Super Bowl, you still have to have a reckoning about how are you going to deal with power and control for African Americans in your league, in a league that was built on their shoulders.
Now, in the meantime, a game did happen, right? And the Buccaneers won, and Tom Brady won his 7th Super Bowl, an incredible achievement. You write about this, and of course, you've written about this for a long time. It's the role of sports in either as a kind of salve or sometimes bringing us together. What did you see last night?
Yeah, well, I mean, listen, I think sports, not the business of sports, but just the competition of sports is great. I mean, Tom Brady is a bad man. I mean, you know, I don't care. And we could say that and go in and celebrate that, not as independents or Democrats or Republicans, but just as people who are cheering for a team. And that's great. And I think the sports is about accountability. You know, just like I said, the scoreboard doesn't lie. I think that we're in this realm where people can invent their own truth. You can't do that in sports. The reality is the reality. The truth is the truth. The scoreboard doesn't lie.
And so what kind of game did you see last night?
Kansas City had their clocks cleaned. You know, I don't care. The fans, you know, if they're, you know, supporters of the former president, the fans can't say, well, Kansas City really won the game. No, you didn't. You lost. You know, go home, get better. That's what everybody saw. That was the truth. Like I said, scoreboards in our business and sport don't lie. That was the truth.
All right. William Roden of The Undefeated, thank you very much.
Thank you. Take care.
Well, remember that. The truth is the truth in what you see in sports.